PHP 8.3 is coming, and with it a handful of deprecations and maybe even some breaking changes. But don't worry, I will guide you through all of them and give you some tips on how to deal with them. First are deprecation notices, and they should be your best friend. They are a great tool in helping to keep your code base up to date without having to deal with too many breaking changes all at once. Now, I made a whole video about dealing with deprecations in general, so you can find a link to that one in the description. PHP 8.3 has some deprecations, which are mostly in order to prepare for PHP 9. Most of the time, a composer update will help you solve them if they happen in vendor code, and otherwise it are pretty small changes you have to make in your own project code. Here's the first deprecation. Using ++ on empty, non-numeric or non-alphanumeric strings is now deprecated. Basically, if you're using ++ on something that it shouldn't be used on, PHP will tell you, hey, this is going to go away in PHP 9, you better fix it. The same goes for minus minus, by the way. There's also a deprecation for calling get class or get parent class without any arguments. PHP 9 will remove that possibility, while for now we get a deprecation notice. There are some changes to the FFI API. You cannot call cast, new or type statically anymore. There are also some function signatures that will change in the future, and PHP is already telling you about that today. A pretty big future change in PHP's SQLite library is that warnings will be replaced with exceptions. Right now, there's this function called enable exceptions that accepts false so that you can disable SQLite exceptions altogether. Well, that's deprecated now, all in preparation for PHP 9. Finally, some older constants have been deprecated as well. Now, I think you're getting the point. PHP internals are working hard to improve PHP, and with that comes some change. And thanks to deprecations, we know about these changes in advance. So don't worry if you run into them. Just check out that video that I mentioned before in the description. Now let's move to breaking changes, because these are things you need to deal with right now, at least if you want to update to PHP 8.3. Now, most of the time, breaking changes, they happen not because developers want to break our code, but because of bug fixes having unforeseen consequences. Now, sometimes, in order to fix code, you have to break it. For example, executing proc get status used to return wrong values if you call it multiple times on POSIX systems. Edge case. I know, but it's fixed now. However, people might have actually written code that relied on these wrong values, meaning that even though it's a bug fix, it's also a breaking change. Traits used to have very weird behavior, where static properties from traits didn't redefine those same properties if they were inherited by parent classes. Edge case. I know. It's fixed now, but it also means that static properties on traits now behave a bit differently and might cause your code to break. Here's an interesting one. If you had an array with a negative index, next added an item to it, then that item would get index 0 instead of the logical next number. Again, probably an edge case, but a bug worth fixing. The next one isn't a bug. It's actually a breaking change because of a new feature added in PHP 8.3. I talked about all new features in a separate video. You know where to find the link. Now, PHP 8.3 adds a way of preventing segfaults when your program is close to memory overflowing because of unintended recursion. Now, in order to detect whether a segmentation fault is about to happen, PHP needs to monitor its memory usage. And when that memory usage is really close to overflowing, PHP will now throw an error instead of running into a segmentation fault. But what if you have a program that's really close to memory overflow, a segmentation fault waiting to happen, but it never reaches that specific point? PHP 8.3 will now throw an error, while previously, your program might have run just fine. Edge case? Probably, but it's something to look out for. Luckily, you can tweak these parameter settings. So if you're running into this newly added recursion error, you can probably fix it by tweaking your ini settings. Next, weak maps that reference themselves can now be garbage collected, which might lead to some unexpected results. There have been quite a lot of changes to PHP's DOM classes, so you might want to read through the list if you rely on those. The opcache consistency checks flag has been removed because it didn't work since PHP 8, which added the JIT. C functions that are wrapped with FFI and which return void now return null in PHP instead of a void object. The file function accepted a flag called file append, which it shouldn't do. That's been fixed. And finally, the range function has gotten a lot of extra checks, making sure no weird data can be passed in. You have probably never done this, and if you did, it's probably by mistake. PHP will now tell you. All in all, I would say these breaking changes and deprecations are for the good of PHP evolving, and they shouldn't cause too much hassle. One final tip I want to give you is to check out an open source tool called Rector, which can help you upgrade your PHP code base for you, and it also knows about these deprecations and breaking changes. So that's it for today. Thanks for watching, like this video, and so on. You know what to do, and I will see you in the next one. Oh, and watch this video next.